So, it is time for me to do another haul. I haven't done a haul in, let me check right now how long it's been since I've been a haul. Since I've done a haul. It's been almost a year since I've done a haul, which is crazy. But I went makeup shopping today to stock up on some items that I was running low on. So I thought I'd just do a video. I was hoping that I wouldn't have to like sit here with this background and I could sit in front of the window or whatever, but it just didn't work out like that. I ended up having to do stuff today and run some errands and whatever, and plus I couldn't get out of bed this morning, which is like every day. So I didn't end up doing that, unfortunately. But here I am, still filming this video anyway in my great lights. Unfortunately, it's not some sunlight, or my great light with some sunlight, but whatever, it's okay. It's okay. Ugh. This pineapple juice has pulp in it. So today I only bought drugstore items. I am gonna stock up on a few other stuff from like offline and stuff, but right now I only just did drugstore because I just felt like being home today. Unfortunately, I came home so late, but whatever, it's okay. It's okay. I need to be at the house sometime, right? So the first thing off I'm going to start this haul with is these eyelashes that I'm wearing right now. I literally just put them on for the sake of this video because I didn't have any others. I'm super duper picky with my lashes, but all the ones that I have at home right now, I don't like them like at all. Like at all. So I just went out and got some new lashes. I had these same pairs like in all my recent videos. I've been wearing these lashes, and these are just Ardell Natural, but they're like kind of like wispy shaped because they have like natural and they have like the different numbers. This is a 120. I love these lashes so much. These are like my new favorites, and I think I'm just gonna go back to them because I remember first time I tried them on when I got them last time, I was like, oh, these are so nice. So I took a picture of the number. Thank God I did, because I completely forgot it and I needed that today as reference. And I love these lashes so much. But with lashes comes my next item, which is this Duo Glue Lash Glue. This is my favorite lash glue. I've tried two other types of lash glue. One was Ardell, that one came, the pack of lashes that I had bought. And then I had another Ardell, which was like kind of black. I didn't really like that one because one, it burnt my lash line. Not, it didn't like burn it, like scald it or whatever. But like I felt it burning and I didn't like that at all. And also it did not make my lashes stick. Like Ardell lash glue is not that great, but their lashes are pretty nice. I always thought this brand was Ardell too. I didn't realize it wasn't Ardell until today, and I realized that Duo was the brand. I thought it was just like a type, a sub brand or subtype in their like brand whatever, but apparently it's not. So yeah, I just got the Duo lash glue, and I got it in the dark tone, that way like when I put on, I don't have to like re-line my upper waterline. It's so hot. It's always so hot in here. Oh my god. The main reason why it's always so hot in here is because the window for this room is not, well, it's broken. The window for this room is broken and I can't open it for the life of us. None of us can open it. It's due to be fixed, but it's been due to be fixed for like how long now? Hopefully I get it done by winter, because once the heating comes up and the lights are on, it's just like way too much and I can't survive that. But anyway, yeah, this is my favorite. I think I'm gonna just stick to this because I just really really like it, and I think it does the best job at keeping my lashes on all day. So yeah, favorite. So I'm gonna go into the stuff that I bought before I bought these lashes. I just wanted to like get that out the way before I forgot that I was wearing them and forgot to mention them. But I want to start with the beauty supply store first. I didn't really get that many, like kind of did, but like I want to start with the beauty supply store stuff first. So I found this beauty supply store up by my house, kind of by my house, and it's just cheaper than all of the others. Like I remember going into the beauty supply stores and the LA Girl foundations were like $4, and all of a sudden now everywhere I go it's always $6, and I guess because that's like the main stretch over there or whatever, but all of their like products are more expensive on that side. And I went on this side over here, which isn't which is kind of a main stretch, but not as busy as that one, not as popular, and not as gentrified. So I guess that's why it's cheaper. So I went over there today and I just picked up some stuff that I needed. Like, first off, I bought some primer. I use this primer in all my videos right now because it's very similar to the Smashbox one, in my opinion, in terms of like the way it feels, and my makeup always lasts. So I mean, that could be a combination of like setting spray and setting powder and this primer, but since I've been wearing it, I haven't had any problems, and it's a much cheaper alternative to the Smashbox. Well, not much cheaper, it's like $10 cheaper, but still cheaper, and I think it comes with more products, so you know, works out better, and it's just like right there, so I can just pick it up anytime. So yeah, this is the LA Girl Pro Prep HD Smoothing Face Primer, and I bought this for $5. So the next item that I bought is my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Chestnut, and as we know, if you watch my videos, I use this to highlight with, and I was running out of it. I was stocked up on that, because every time I ran out of another one, I ran out of one, I had another one behind it, so I was like, oh snap, when did I even buy all of these? But I ran out of my supply, so I just needed to get another one today, so I just picked up one of these. I was trying to go higher in color, but it seems like that color that's next after this is Toffee, and I just think it's too light for me. I swatched them, and it was dark cocoa, then it was chestnut, and then it was espresso, then it was Toffee. But dark cocoa and espresso look like the same shade to me, and honestly, this looks lightest, so that would be best for highlighting for me and my skin tone, and not making me look super ashy and crazy. So yeah, got this. Okay, so what I was most excited about that I picked up at the drugstore today, the main reason I went there was because it was cheaper, but one of the reasons why I went there today was because I saw these last time. What do these look like to you? Whose brand of products does these look like to you? I got these because they reminded me of the Kylie Jenner lip kits. When I saw them, I was like, they have fake Kylie Jenner lip kits here. Aren't those dangerous? And then I looked closer, and it wasn't Kylie Jenner dupes or fakes or whatever. I mean, it is a dupe, but it wasn't Kylie Jenner. It wasn't meant to be that brand, whatever. So when I looked closer, it was actually Ruby Kisses, and I'm like, wow, I've been using Ruby Kisses products a lot lately. Well, not a lot, but like, I've been picking up more of their products lately, and they have really, what I feel like, have been stepping up the game since like when I was in like high school or whatever. Because when I swatched these, and I still have on the swatches now from what I took earlier, and I wash my hands, I wipe my hands, it's been like 4 hours now, maybe? Yeah, it's probably been like 4 hours, and they haven't budged. So I'm going to show you guys swatches of the colors I got later in this video, or maybe I'll do a separate video on them, I'm not sure. If this is too long, we'll see. But if I do a separate video, it will most definitely be up a little bit after or before this one, so you won't have to wait long, or it'll already be up. So yeah, if you want to see that. But I just got these. I got 5 shades, and the best thing about them, guess how much these cost, guys? I don't know why they cost this price, but I am not complaining. Guess how much they cost. Just guess how much they cost. Guess these cost $2 each. I bought 5 of them for $10. Like, why, you know, when something's like so cheap and then you just get suspicious, like, why are you so cheap? Like, why? And it looks like a pretty good product, but what's going on? Like, what is up with this? I most definitely shouldn't have bought 5 of them before I tried out one. But you know, these swatches look pretty good, so whatever it is that might be it, I can handle it for $2. For $2, I can handle it. I got like a few super dark pinks. I didn't go for any light pinks because I already have like a bunch of light pinks, so So I went for dark pinks. I wanted a purple matte lip, so I got purple and I got a nude because I had a nude lip. I had a nude liquid lipstick. Like, I'm positive I had a nude liquid lipstick. I'm positive I had a nude liquid lipstick, and I don't know, it just vanished off of the face of the earth. And I just recently remembered that, like, I had one because I most definitely filmed a video with it that I didn't put up, and it's just like, where's that? Where did that go? So I was like, okay, I'm gonna get another one. So yeah, and see how I like them, and then maybe I'll get some more. But we'll see. We'll see. No guarantees. I won't promise anything. So yeah, that's all I got from the beauty supply store today. I'm gonna show you now the rest of what I got from Target, and then that'll be the end of this video. Or will it? It depends how long it is. We'll see. So the next thing that I bought is something that I absolutely freaking love. Like, oh my god. It is this Simple Micellar Cleansing Water. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but I'll like literally type it out here for you guys, like how it's spelled. But yeah, it's the Simple Micellar. Anyway, I got this Simple, whatever that is. And this is just a makeup remover. This is so good, guys. Like, if you have not tried taking your makeup off with this, you are missing out, because this is so good. And the size of it is so worth it. This cost me like $6, and this bottle is massive. This is like, I'd say about 3 packs of makeup wipes. It's worth it. Like, I try to put every single person onto this because it is just so good. Like, I tried this one, and I think I tried a NYX one, and this one is most definitely better, so I had to come back to it. And there's also the Garnier one. I'm pretty sure a lot of beauty gurus have like recommended the Garnier one, but I've tried the Simple one and I love the Simple one. So I don't know, whichever one you want to get, it's up to you. But you most definitely need to try this out because it's so good and it's so worth it. Like, it just gets your makeup off so quickly. Like, literally, you could get one pad of one cotton pad, wipe all your makeup off, and then wash the rest off with a cleanser, as I would usually do. I don't ever like wipe my makeup off and then not wash with a cleanser, because I just like, how deep is this really getting, or how deep is a makeup wipe really getting? So yeah, I always, you know, do that. So the next thing I got is these Real Techniques sponges. If you've been watching my videos lately, I have been complaining about my sponges being so like grungy or like grimy. I mean, they're clean and whatever, but it's just like, they're all like torn up now. It's just like time to get a new pair, and I finally gotten a new pair, and I've been waiting to do a haul just so I could get a new pair and show them to you guys, so it could all be like wrapped up in one thing. And I'm happy to finally have gotten these are my absolute favorite blending sponges. I think they do such a good job, and they do last a really long time, so it's definitely worth it. And I think they have like a little bit of a new design on them, because it now has the Real Techniques logo on the sponge. So yeah, it's a little bit different. They look a little bit smaller to me, but they're probably not. This is a really good blending sponge. Like, if you want an alternative to the beauty blender, which is like $20 a sponge, I haven't tried that yet, because I don't have $20 to spend on one sponge. I really don't. But yeah, you can always try this. This has two sponges in it. It's like number two to a beauty blender, because I see a bunch of like YouTubers use it. And this only cost me $11, so you get two sponges for $11. Like, I got this from Target. At some Targets though, they do sell them more expensive, so you just gotta really like fish around for which one has it cheapest, and then just like buy it there if you care. I care, because we need to find them deals. Yeah. Yes, these are amazing. If you haven't tried them, these are another thing that you should try, and they're more affordable, so you don't really lose out anywhere at all. So Why not? And lastly from Target, I bought a new contour. So I was like fishing around for contours on YouTube, and this one was mentioned like 3 times out of the videos that I watched. So I was like, let me just try this. It only cost me $4, and I think it also comes with a, what is this? Oh, a blush. I don't know. I might use that, who knows, I might not. So yeah, I'm just gonna like try it out on camera for you guys. There's a bit of gold flecks in it. My contour right now is pretty just like brown. Oh my gosh. So like someone took a swatch of this. Like I can literally see the fingerprint in there. Do you see that? Like little dark, like someone put their finger in there. It took me so long just to go to Target, guys. It took me so long just to go to Target. And now I have to go back because someone wanted to be a little, I don't know, what? Why didn't you just go to the Elf store now? You made my life miserable. I'm just kidding. But like, jeez. The blush is really pretty though. I do like the gold flecks in them. Gold looks really nice, but I don't know if I want that as a contour. Well, it's a bronzer, but you know. I'm highly disappointed about this. The blush looks really pretty though. It looks more like a highlight than a blush, to be honest. And the bronzer, I don't know how I feel about that. I've never used bronzer before, actually. But I've seen the girls use this to contour with. Oops, no. Go ahead and swatch it. It's actually really pretty. It's a really nice brown, actually. I'm gonna return it anyway though, because I bought it like that. But yeah, you can see that. And once you can see from here, you know it's pretty good. So yeah, I mean, I can most definitely use this, I think. I don't really like the shimmer. I most definitely like to get another one without the shimmer in it. Not that I don't like it, I just prefer to have one without the shimmer in it. I mean, like, this would be really good if, like, I was doing, like, glowy makeup look. That would be so pretty. But I don't want this for all the time. So, yeah, I'm most definitely still going to have to go find another, like, contour. But this can work for now. I mean, not this one because I have to return it because someone wants to take it out the box and swatch it. And I want to pick up the one that someone swatched. That's it for this haul, you guys. This video isn't gonna be that long, so I'm just gonna insert the little swatch part of those lipsticks that I got. So yeah, I hope you enjoy that.
She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man. Pretty ass, middle ass, nigga with a sick ass mouth and a slick ass flow. Catch a bitch around.